motivational quotes videos, facts videos, philosophical videos. There are several types of YouTube videos that can be created just using stock footages. But apart from the stock footage, you will also need a few other elements like copyright-free music track, video transition effects to create such videos. In this video, we will show you where to find all these elements and create a YouTube video that looks something like this. But before we begin, a gentle reminder to all the viewers who haven't subscribed to the channel, please subscribe for more videos like this. Click on the link in the description to visit the website of Animaker. Click on the create option and you'll be redirected to the sign up page. Fill in the details and create a new account. You'll be directed to the dashboard. Click on the create option on the left, followed by selecting create a video and blank page. This is the interface of the Animaker application. On the center is the workspace where you'll be creating your videos. On the right hand side is the scenes section. Scenes are similar to what you call slides in a presentation. As the slides combine to form a presentation, several scenes combine to form a video. On the bottom is the timeline. Within timeline, we have three different timelines, starting from the animation timeline, then we have the video and audio timeline, and finally we have the camera timeline. On the left is the library, which consists of all the assets like animated characters, stock images and videos, music tracks and other elements that you will need to create your YouTube videos. Let's start with adding the stock footage to the scenes. There are two ways to add the stock videos. You can use the videos present inside the Animaker's library and add it to the scenes, or you can upload your own stock videos using the upload section. You can find free stock videos on sites like Pexels and Pixabay. You can just download them and upload using the upload section and use it in your projects. For this video, I'm going to use the stock videos present inside the app. Go to the video section in the library, search for the video that you need. I want to give an adventurous kind of look to this whole video, so I'll be using a lot of sports related stock videos. For the first quote, I'm adding a cycling related visual. You can see there are a lot of options. I'm going to use this one over here. Once I click on it, you can see the video appearing on the center of the screen, which we call as workspace. You can also notice a set of options appearing along with the video. This is the item menu of this video. Here, within that item menu, we have an option to trim the video. I want this video to be 10 seconds long. You can notice a watermark in the center of the workspace, but you don't have to worry about it because it won't be visible in the final output of your video. But if you are using a free version of the application, there will be a small watermark at the bottom of the video saying created using Animaker. But the one on the center won't be there in the final output of your video. Now it's time to add the quote. Go to the text section in the library and click on one of the text boxes. So this is the list of quotes I'm going to add to this video. Totally there are 5 different quotes, so we'll be creating 5 different scenes. I'm just going to copy and paste the quote into the text box. And I'll be adding separate text boxes for each of the lines so that I can add animation effect to them separately. You can also notice a new purple color bar on the timeline. This bar represents the duration for which this text is going to be visible. So if I want the text to appear a little later, just select and drag the left edge of the bar towards the right. According to the current position, the first sentence will appear after 2 seconds, and the second sentence will appear after 4 seconds from the start of the scene. On the right hand side, you can notice the settings tab in open. Using these options, you can control the font style, size, color, even the transparency. you can notice two options named Enter and Exit effect. With them, we can apply Enter and Exit animations to the elements. I'm going to give a simple fade-in effect. You can notice a new pink color part in the timeline. It represents the duration for which this animation effect is going to take place. By default, it is 1 second, but you can always increase or decrease the duration of the animation effect. Now I'm going to the properties section of the library and selecting this shape over here. The cool thing about these shapes is that they are totally customizable. Let me reduce the width of this line. Let's give it a different color and also apply an animation effect. To have a preview of a scene, use the preview option just above the timeline. That's it, we have created the scene number one. So let's go on and create the next scene. We can create a new scene using the add scene option in the scene section. But the smart way is to duplicate the current scene using the duplicate option over here and edit over it. Now we have to just replace the clip and edit the text. For the second quote, I want a visual in which someone is hiking. Let's edit the text. In the same way, I'm going to duplicate the scenes, replace the video, and edit the text. I have completed creating the video. For the last scene, I want to add an outro. Get back to the dashboard and click on the intro outro category. Now preview the outros and click on the use option to use it. Right now, this outro is opened as a separate project. Our YouTube video is in a separate project. But don't worry, just press Ctrl+C if you are using Windows and Command+C in case of Mac and copy the scene from this project. Now get back to the project where we were creating the YouTube video. Go to the last scene and press Ctrl+V or Command+V to paste the scene. It's that simple. Now click on the text boxes, type in the new text and customize it as you wish. Let's add a music track to this project. Go to the music section present at the bottom of the library. There are more than 30,000 copyright free music tracks over here. Keep the pointer of the mouse over a music track to have a preview of it. Click on the track to add it to the timeline. If you further click on the track, you will find a few more options to control it. You can preview the audio, control its volume, duplicate it, and delete it. As the last step, let's add the transition effects. Click on the option between two scenes. Now you can select among the 50 plus different transition effects. In the same way, go to each of the scene and add transition effect. To have a preview of all the scenes together, use the preview option at the top. To download the video, go to the publish option at the top, click on the download video option and then download. Now you know how to create a YouTube video just using stock footages. So what are you waiting for? Go on and create your YouTube video now.